Namaste. This is the operation theater number 2 in Karthik Netralaya. As you can see here, there is one single table in the center, and the staff are planning to do the weekly chorus, that is cleaning the entire OT, starting from the roof, from the ceiling to the walls and the floor. So this is how they're going to do it. Basically, all the machines, all the chairs, all the tables are present on the wheels so that it's easy for them. The stainless steel trolleys are, you know, as you can see here, they're moved to half portion, that's a half portion of it. So they're going to clean the other half portion, and then they'll move the instruments to the other area and clean this portion. It's easy if they're on the wheels. If it's not on the wheels, they'll have difficulty in shifting it from place to place. To introduce OT, in the center, we keep the OT table obliquely so that we have more space on the head end, as you can see here. And microscope is on the left side of this, and it's very, very convenient whether you're doing the right eye or left eye, even from the temporal side. And all the monitors and anesthetic goods and the television, which records the recording system, they're all placed there. There are many of these small monitors here, as you can see there. Now we are switched off the air conditioner. Temperature has gone up to 25.9, and the humidity is 67%. We keep the humidity around 50%, 40 to 50% all the time by two methods. One is, as long as the air conditioner is on, AC will maintain it. When the AC is switched off, we have a gadget called dehumidifier that you can see here. We put it on. We switch off the dehumidifier at the end of the day. We don't run it at night time. And the moment the staff come in the morning, they switch it on again. Humidity does go up in the night, but it generally is around 60s and 65s. That suffices for us. And we also have central oxygen supply to all the theaters with central air supply, compressed air supply, to operate the phaco machine or the vitrectomy machine as and when it's needed. That's the control unit for air conditioner. And the air comes inside through the ducts, as you can see here on the rooftop. And we have a stainless steel false roofing, which can be opened up and cleaned at any point of time. That's a central grid or central area where the air flows down, the filtered and cool air flows down onto the operation theater area. It's a large one which has been calculated depending upon the air exchanges that we need and the temperature and humidity that we need to maintain. The electrical supply pendants are present on the roof, so there are no wires which are present anywhere on the floor. There's a natural supply of light here, as you can see, but it's double covered. There is one glass here, so that shelves are not there. There's no horizontal surface anywhere. Outside also it's sandwiched so that the noise from outside does not come. That's a sandwiched glass on the outside. This is a plain glass inside, tempered glass. And noise from outside will not trouble us, because three glasses will totally prevent the noises coming out. They are the return ducts. There are three return ducts. The air that comes in through the top area comes down, and as a lamina flow, it goes outside, picked up at the two slots, and it goes up there. And then all the four corners are covered by this, and then it goes out through the return air ducts. And I'll show you the beautiful AHUs that we maintain outside the theater. They're going to start cleaning the area. So it's a three bucket system of cleaning. One of them will have a detergent, which is cleaning area. A lot of operation theaters do not use detergent, but detergent is one of the first thing that you should use. And you can start the work. And he has finished cleaning the ceiling. Now he's going to clean the wall. One of my technician, detergent, soap. So this is a very handy cleaner. He'll show you how it is fixed. This is a reusable mop stick, extremely useful for operation theaters and especially for the ceiling and the walls. It goes locked into that. And he's going to clean from one end to the other end. And after cleaning certain area, this mop is can be this mop can be removed and is put in plain water and squeezed and then it goes into the soap solution. The third bucket will have bacillocid after a certain area, after one wall is cleaned, and the bacillocid is used for the other wall. Bacillocid is a strong chemical, is disinfectant, while the detergent only removes the dirt. If you remove the dirt, that's good enough. For daily maintenance, what you need is remove the dirt, not the disinfection. Now he's finished certain area, that will be removed. Now that will go into the plain water. So the dirt which is picked up is left in the plain water, and remove the water, wring it up, and then put it in the soap solution. Now he puts in the detergent. Fresh detergent goes into the mop, and then he'll assemble it and then go to the rest of the wall. So this cycle keeps on happening, and after this they'll start doing the floor. You can show the floor how we go to clean now this time. Clean the floor.
Floor.
We'll just demo the floor. Floor. So now he'll bring another one. In the meantime, he'll continue cleaning with the... you can continue doing that. So that you by tiles remember which areas are cleaned and which areas not cleaned. Tile by tile he goes from one end to the other end. So this picks up dust from the wall, and it's not important to keep the wall sterile. No disinfectant can sterilize the surface. Sterilization is only done by autoclaving or E2O sterilization or from the plasma or H2O2 systems. The disinfectants will never remove all the germs and spores from the wall, but it will reduce the amount of the germs and spores that you have on the wall. And we'll show the floor. Can you go on to the floor? The floor is cleaned by a mop like that, and it's again, we have discovered the system with great difficulty. Can you show how it is? Okay. Now go along the lines, tile by tile, so that you don't miss out any area. So he'll cover certain portion. Now come back and clean it now. Come back. As you can see here, these are all vitrified tiles. There is space in between the vitrified tiles, which is filled by grouting. This is so that it becomes mono surface. There are no crevices between the grouting area, which is epoxy, and the tile. It's fully packed, so germs cannot go inside and live there or thrive there. So this is a very good system, and there is no space behind this. Stainless steel grids will always have space behind this, and it's never possible to completely isolate them. In my personal opinion, this is the best way to treat your walls. Now the mop that he has used goes inside. It's again water. It's again water. Then it goes to the detergent, not disinfectant. There's a huge that soap. Yeah, that's plain soap. Soap? Yeah, soap. There are three kinds of detergents in the market. One of them is neutral detergent, other is acidic, the other is alkaline. It's best to have a neutral detergent. It's available. We purchased all the detergents available in the market, and we detected two or three brands which are neutral by pH meter, and we use that. Basically, they are dishwashing soaps that are available in the market. One of the brands you can pick up depending upon the local availability and use that to clean it. So every part of the operation theater floor is cleaned, including this. This is a weekly affair. The walls and ceiling and the floor is cleaned weekly. But the floor is cleaned every 1 hour during the surgery session. And at the end of surgery, we treat again. The third bucket that we have is the bacillocid. First to clean, as I said, with soap. The water is used to clean the mops. And next round is going to be bacillocid. So now after finishing this, they'll treat every area very similar to what he has done just now with the bacillocid solution. We do not fumigate our operation theater. So once half of the theater is cleaned like this, he is going to shift all the instruments, including the microscope, all trolleys to the left side of my operation theater. They clean on the other side of it. So it takes about how long it will take to complete? The one small theater like this, which measures 18.5 feet by 18 feet, takes about 2 hours to clean it. So we have three theaters. All the three theaters are clean. They have designated different days so that it's not a load on them. And we have the cleaning of the entire common areas, the autoclave room, everything is cleaned the same way. So this keeps the area absolutely clean. And there should not be any horizontal surfaces, as you can see here. And horizontal surfaces, if they are there, like they are there on the top of the pendant, they are there on the top of the trolleys, so that has to be cleaned at least once a day with wet mops. The best to clean the stainless steel surface is the alcohol mops or wet mops for detergent. So both are equally good. But when you want quick cleaning, like on the top of the trolley in between surgery, alcohol mop is all right. What we do is on the top of the trolley, can you bring that plastic cover to open it up? I'll show you how it's done in the beginning of the day. We have ETO sterilized the plastic drapes. This cannot be sterilized by any means. Whatever you do, you can only disinfect it. You cannot sterilize it. So what we do is in the beginning of the surgery, we put a plastic drape on it. And all the later surgeries, we just change the towels. Can you open it and put there? Show them. This is an unsterile technique. It is not scrubbed. Open it, put it up. But he ensures the top portion of the drape is untouched. So that he is touching his down portion. Basically, it is a plastic drape, which is available commercially. Inside portion is not touched. So, and he'll stick it on all the four sides with tape. So the top of it has become sterile now, and the cloth drapes are put on this. So even if the cloth drape becomes wet for that matter, and percolates down, the underlying surface is also sterile. So this is one good way of ensuring that the water just spurts on the trolley will not percolate and get contaminated by the dirt or unsterile surface of the stainless steel. As I said, all the instruments that are used in any surgery for that matter, whatever may be it, maybe it's cannula, maybe it's one of the solutions, maybe pylocar, maybe the drops, moxie, flox, whatever it is, they are never used. All the eye drops are opened up every day in the morning and sent outside at the end of the day. For example, we have a paracaine, proparcaine eye drops, moxie, floxin eye drops, any eye drops like pylocar eye drops, in case we constrict the pupil, homotropin eye drops, they're never kept over to the next day. So they're all sent outside, and probably we'll not discard them, we'll use it in the outpatient department. These are by following very strict discipline, very strict way of working, and this is controlled by a HD camera. From outside, from my mobile, I can cross-check whether things are happening all right. That can be done by, there is a music playing around, and the dirt is number one enemy in the operation theater. And we have no UV lights, but we have portable UV lights. Whenever the area gets contaminated, we bring a portable UV light and connect it to this, and switch is outside. We can switch on and switch off from outside. So UV light is not regularly used. We have never fumigated this. There is no need for fumigation. Fumigation should not be done because it's toxic to human beings. And also fumigation will give you a temporary mental satisfaction. For example, if there is a tray like that, and you know the underlying surface of this, neither the your uvulate goes, or your formalin vapor goes inside it. So the inside, if it is, it can remain unsterile. The next thing is, by the time you enter, all the formalin has gone outside. There's no more formalin inside. The moment you go, moment you get inside, you see that the formalin is neutralized. So where is the question of sterilization? It cannot sterilize anything. It can, it maybe it disinfects whatever that is on the visible on the surface, but it is not sterile. So fumigation is totally avoided, and you can, he'll show you how he is going to clean the So that is the microfiber sponge he has. He's going to clean the entire surface. It's moistened. It can be moistened, and later he's going to clean it up. He has already done it, so he's just showing how it's done. Every tile is cleaned by that method he's going to show. So the prevention of infection, prevention of contamination, endophthalmitis is more related to how we keep the operation theater rather than how it is built. Building an operation theater is an art. Maintaining is an art and a science. So both combined together, you can minimize the risk of contamination. Thank you.